Hi people, as promised, I have slowed down with my vlogging. That's quite on schedule. I was really supposed to pretty much stop in February of this year, and now it's May, and I really haven't, but I have slowed down. The last video I tried to upload, it took me 3 attempts. It was rather frustrating. Okay, I mention this book a lot, particularly in my comments on YouTube. And I got this book either in the late 1980s or the early 1990s, and I've taken really good care of it. It's easy to find, and it's considered a classic. Juicing for Life by Sherry Kalbaum and Maureen Kane. And it's just got a lot of basic juicing information in here, and I noticed that, well, it's very well indexed. You know, it's got lots and lots of references, carefully detailed, and it's very well indexed. So if there's a particular thing that you are being bothered by as far as your health goes, or that you want to do, such as find out if you have any food intolerances, or if you have some health problems, or certain nutrients that you'd like to find out about, you can look them up quite well here. just a lot of good stuff in here. And I note over the years that I've referenced this book, it's the information is very good. Really, these people really knew what they were doing. I had a very bad attack of gout this spring, and I chose to try to deal with it naturally. Thank you very much. A couple of people sent me very good suggestions, such as eating some cherries and having a little bit of fresh orange after that. One guy told me have a little pineapple. These things did turn out to be very, very helpful. And a very nice lady on YouTube who I'm not sure she wants to be to have her username mentioned or not, told me that she's troubled with a bad cough these days, and I quit smoking again recently, and I have a bad cough also. And although I didn't specifically find coughing stuff in here, I did find quite a bit about dealing with common colds and bronchitis and stuff like that. I do have health problems, and I've become increasingly physically disabled, especially over the last 10 years. And I want to get through that without classic toxic medication to the extent possible. And I have managed to overcome some problems, such as asthma and allergies. I've identified some food intolerances, and I'm still not in perfect shape. And I did use a weight loss juicing diet from this book years ago that was fantastic, and it kept the weight off for years. So when I feel a little bit better, I'm going to do that, most likely. The elimination diet is in this book. It's very easy to follow. It's not expensive. It's not difficult. You do it for 2 weeks, and then you begin adding foods back into your diet one at a time, and you just keep a little written journal about how that makes you feel. And that's how I found out that I'm gluten intolerant, and the nightshade family bothers me a great deal. Stuff like that. So for the lady with the cough, there are some things in here, some suggestions, such as how to reduce mucus in your bronchial tubes. You know, no alcohol, no sugar or honey or fructose, limited dairy products. I like plain herbal tea in the evenings without any sweeteners in it at all or anything. Certainly not artificial sweeteners. And here's an immune support diet. Some comments on sweeteners. Refined white flour. Avoiding alcohol, coffee, and black tea. But herbal teas are okay. Eliminating junk food. Going with whole unprocessed foods. Garlic, onions, ginger, shiitake mushrooms. These things enhance the immune functions. Green juice drinks. Foods high in omega-3 fatty acids. Not all of these, such as sardines and mackerel, are good for people like myself with gout. But you can adjust it as you like. Now this is chronic fatigue syndrome, remember that? And I do recommend the Kneipp method, K-N-E-I-P-P. There's quite a bit on the internet about it. The book, My Water Cure, which is a 19th century book, is free on the internet, and it's quite easy to find old copies of it for cheap, or new editions. You know, it's been in the public domain for a long, long, long time. Colitis, how to deal with stuff like that. How to deal with peanut butter cravings. That's kind of cute. It took me years to even find peanut butter for sale here in France. They're really not into stuff like that here. Depression. Very useful book. You know, sometimes you really ought to realize that you might need classic medicine. I try to work with doctors here in France and give them printed materials in French for them to consider, and alternative medicines and treatments do exist here. Quite a few that I'd never heard about in the United States. So I really recommend this book. This is stuff for memory loss, menopause, all kinds of stuff. Of course, there are some other really, really good books. I have one called The Self-Healing Cookbook. It's a little bit too macrobiotic for me, and there are a lot of health foods mentioned in there that I just really cannot get, especially not here in France. And how to deal with prostate problems. Stop drinking beer, for one thing. I know also that chickpeas, garbanzo beans, are good for that. All right, see you later. Bye.